I'm having a micro adventure. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Safe journey.
Town behind now. I'm into the open countryside and heading out to a place called Badbury Wick, and I've got a little bit of an uphill climb and I'm going to call in and see a couple of friends before I head out onto the higher ground where I'm hopefully going to camp at some point tonight. Very minimalistic setup I've got. This isn't for everybody. Anyway, yeah, look, how about that for a nice home? I could live there quite happily. I'm climbing now, not too steep. I'm in the lowest gear, doing about 9 miles an hour. Getting some air in my lungs, it's good. There's cottages behind where my father-in-law was brought up. The green cottage. Stopping off at this little it's a little enterprise and a few little businesses here. One of them's Bulldog paramotors. This is where they make the Bulldog paramotors.
We're having a cup of coffee.
There's Clive on the left and there's Tony on the right, our working duo this.
It's just going through its startup phase, but it's quite a nice one, this one. Well, quite an expensive machine as well, but it's all touch screen, Wi-Fi, cameras inside so I can remote view the process of what's going on.
Yeah.
But no, I love 3D printing because it allows for something that's in your head to come to fruition with a tangible part that you can rotate in your hand and, like I say, offer up and see.
Yeah.
How it works for real life, but like I said, the other beautiful thing is that you can make bespoke tooling and so forth to hold in the mills. If you've got a complicated shape that needs to be held well, you can make the reverse shape in plastic, and then you can clamp it down in the vices in the mills. So yeah. That's good. So
yeah. Well, thanks for showing us around, Clive. I'll see you later. See you later, Tom. We're going flying soon.
See you tomorrow on your way back.
I'll call in for a cup of coffee.
Yeah.
Well, see you then.
Alright, see you later, mate.
I was unsure where I was going to be going tonight. I haven't chatted to Tony and Clive at Bulldog Paramotors. I've decided to head out now on the cycle track and possibly end up in Savernake Forest for an overnighter. Looking a bit grey. Don't know if you can see the grey clouds over there. I think we're going to be in for a wet night, perhaps. This used to be a railway line. It goes all the way to Marlborough. Thank you. quite pleasant cycling along this track. It's not too bumpy, it's quite level, and making reasonable progress. Old railway building there. Just cycled past a sign which indicated a part of the Ridgeway route which I've walked on numerous occasions. In fact, I've walked the Ridgeway four times now. Anyway, the track continues on. You can't see it, but either side of me is lovely open land, open countryside. The track itself is quite shaded. Might get a glimpse of some open land here. And a view to the hills that way. The Ridgeway's up there. I'll tell you, I'm really enjoying this bicycle ride. Beautiful views. There's a busy road just to my right, unfortunately. But the views across that and over to the valley the other side, quite nice. Bit bumpy just there. But the route itself, I've travelled 10 miles along it now, and I've met two joggers and one cyclist. So hardly rush hour, is it? And just look at it. Lovely old railway bridges. I just stopped here, a nice little seat. Thought I'd take the opportunity to get off the bike and sit down and just enjoy the view. There's a funny sort of pyramid, concrete pyramid on the route here. I've got my bike propped up against it. But the view across the valley is quite beautiful. And I guess that's obviously Marlborough over there. Just come across this rather quaint metal cast iron, or possibly aluminium, finger post. Telling us where we've been, where we're going to, where we're from. I'm heading up to Savernake Forest. Footpath, it says. That way. As you can see, I've made it into the forest. I'm at Savernake. Beautiful forest. I've had to push the bike up the hill and along the track, the footpath rather, because you can't really cycle along it just here. Well, further on I can see you possibly could, but back there you had to push really. So I'm going to get into the forest, find myself a place to stop for a little while. I've got a meal to prepare. I've got no stove. So I'll bring you along for that. I'll have a snack to eat, have a bit of a rest, and then I think I'm going to explore Savernake on the bike, and then eventually, within the next couple of hours, find somewhere where I can set up camp for the night. Got the hoop bivy, and I'm doing really ultra stealth camping. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. We could even have some rain later. Well, I've come into the forest and I've come in a way that I don't normally come into this forest, and I'm lost. I followed the animal, I think they became animal tracks. It was quite a defined footpath and it petered out, and I'm lost. So I think what I'm going to do is actually have my break here, sit down, gather myself. I've got a cold soak my evening meal, so I'll do that. I've bought a couple of snacks, and I'll have a couple of snacks now, it tied me over. Still got loads of sunlight. I put my hand up, Oh, I've got about 3 hours yet before sundown. So the plan is to get my food rehydrating and then to find out where I am in the wood, in the forest rather. It's about 30 square kilometres here. Get on some known tracks and start exploring and then find a campsite at some point. But, yeah, very peaceful. This is my cook pot. This is all I've got. And I've got my meal, main meal for tonight. Tin of mackerel. That's coffee for tomorrow morning. And enough couscous to feed two. The pot, I've got a little mark on the pot. It's 160 mils there. So, it's gonna fill up to the 160 mils. Which is about there. Add the couscous. With the couscous added. Seal the lid. And give it a shake. And then that's gonna slowly rehydrate over the next hour or so. And then I'll have it to eat at some point tonight before I go to sleep. Well, I've been walking through the forest for about 20 minutes. Quite tough going actually. But I've come upon the openings that I recognise. So I think I know where I am there. I'm on one of the main drives now through Savernake, and all these paths are all interlinked. They go on for miles, and this one's going to take me eventually down to the Grand Avenue, and I think I'm going to go all the way along the Grand Avenue. Just look at that. How beautiful is that? I cycled to the edge of the forest to the main London road, and I'm heading back into the forest. This time I'm at the Grand Avenue. There's the main gates. Savernake Forest. This is a 3.5 mile long avenue apparently. Bike's holding up well. I'm now at Eight Ways, so here they are, that's the way I just came. that way, that goes back to the main road. And these are the eight ways. I'm going to continue along to the end of the Grand Avenue, and I can say I've done it. This is fast. Well, I've made it almost. Just a few more feet to go, and I've cycled the length of the Grand Avenue of Savernake. Yeah. That's as far as I can go. So obviously it goes on, but the way is barred. So there's looking back to the way I just came. So I'm going to head on back down there again now, try and find somewhere to camp. It's 8:05. Getting quite tired now. I've come off the beaten track. Got this quite thick covered behind me. Potential spot just down there, I think. I've got a more open perspective this way. And that's the way I've got to head back tomorrow to get home. So I think I might just bivy down here tonight. Well, camp is set up. Snapping food. I was moving away actually just to see what it looks like from a distance. I'm about 40 yards away from the Grand Avenue. I think that's quite low profile. I'll bring you in for a closer look in a minute. Let's have a zoom in. So there's camp on the edge of that piece of woodland. So it's a camouflage tarp. Very, very low profile. Underneath is the Dutch Army hoop bivy. I don't know if you can see much. That's the Dutch Army hoop bivy. In there I've got my thermarest, and I've got my snug pack hammock under quilt, which I'm using as a top quilt. And then the bike also is undercover as well. And the reflectors have been covered over, so if anyone shines a torch down here in the night, there's never been no light bouncing back. Couscous. That's rehydrated okay. Just got to enjoy eating it cold. So I'm looking forward to getting some good kip tonight. I'm quite tired actually. I missed a bite now on 25-30 mile. Anyway, let's see what it's like. Surprisingly good actually. I could live on this. For a little while at least. I think I'll have the fish. And the oil. All good calories. Alright, I'm going to get undercover and eat it. I away from prying eyes. I'm safely installed now in my bivy. There's my food down there. Don't think you can see much, it's getting a bit dark. That's my view out. Very peaceful. Just been woken by a bark of a muntjac deer. It's gone 5 o'clock. Deer's over there somewhere. It's only a small deer. Making a hell of a racket though. Sun just starting to come up. Anyway, just got to get myself back to the avenue, the road. It's only about 20 yards away. I was down there. Quick pack up. Took me 20 minutes to get the camp struck down and myself ready for the road. I got my breakfast. A flapjack. And I'll find a nice spot on the way back home, and I'll eat me flapjack for breakfast. This looks rather nice. Sunlight, early morning sunlight, streaming through the trees as I cycle along the Grand Avenue. What a way to start the day. Approaching the end of the Grand Avenue again, 3.5 miles each way, so that far end and back to here, 7 miles. Anyway, at this point this is where I say goodbye to this lovely forest and enter the modern world for a little while before picking up that Sustrans route. I found my way back onto the Sustrans route. A fair bombed along here, to be honest with you, and I'm just looking for a nice place now. Just looking for a nice place to stop for my flapjack. I'm really enjoying the cycling along the Sestrans trail. Nice place to stop, have my flapjack for breakfast. I'm about two-thirds of the way home now, and it's only 5 to 7 in the morning. And you can make some pretty good progress on a bike. Trusty old bike. I've had that bike probably getting on 15 years now, I suppose. I haven't used it a great deal. I think I'm going to use it a lot more now. It's a Diamondback. I don't think they make that model anymore. Anyway, hope you've enjoyed the video. I feel I've had a mini adventure. Hope you'll join me on the next one. Bye for now. I find it incredible to think that just 2.5 hours ago, what's it, just gone 8 now in the morning, just 2.5 hours ago I was striking camp in a forest, a beautiful forest, a good day, perhaps day and a half trek away, and 2.5 hours on that bike, it's got me back home to my door. That's an adventure. Is it open? Oh yeah, it's open. Oh. There she is, look, the coffee maker. You make me a nice cup of coffee. Cup of coffee. Oh. Get the kettle on.